Welcome back to my show. I'm the Beer Adventurer.
I'm Carissa.
And on this episode, I've got one from Lexington Brewing. This is the Kentucky Ale Irish Red. Now, what makes this one interesting is this is the only one of theirs that I know of that I've ever had that wasn't barrel aged. Mm-hmm. Which I was kind of under the impression at first that everything they did was barrel aged, because everything I had was barrel aged.
Right.
I think everything that you've had from
them. I
think
so.
Was barrel aged. Now you read the bottle, and what was it? This was the cross between.
It's a blend between an Irish ale and an English
pale
ale.
And it says it's 5.3.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Now it said it was. What were those?
You gonna make me put my glasses on camera, aren't okay. you? Okay. You tell me.
I don't have the light coming.
It has Fugles and East Kent Goldings hops. Taste notes are balanced, slightly sweet, big malt backbone, clean and refreshing finish.
Okay. Okay. I don't know that I've had this one.
I don't think, I know I don't, I'm almost positive I have not.
Got the traditional, nice kind of tannish head. From an Irish Red. Okay, I'm not sure if she's gonna like it near as much as I will, but I'm a big Red fan.
It smells malty.
I like that. Kind of got a clean smell.
Mm-hmm. I smell malt.
I like it. Okay, that one's. This is not barrel aged.
That's good though.
It's super clean.
Mm-hmm.
There is a malt.
Huge malt backbone, but there is a hop note to it.
Yeah, but it's
it's very small.
The hop note is red.
Mm-hmm.
It's not negative. It's not resinous. It's not piney.
It doesn't stick around.
It's just the. Hops
it's just there.
For a red.
Yeah, it's just there. It is very malt forward.
Oh, I like that.
Mm-hmm. That's good. I like it.
I'm a little bit surprised on the. Tingle?
Yeah.
At the beginning. Seems like it's got a little more the effervescence. I'm not upset about that at all.
Yeah.
I like that. Which kind of balances that real hoppy thing that comes not hoppy, very malty that comes afterwards. There is a little bit of malt. Okay. Effervescence, malt, slight hop dissipation.
Yeah.
The hops feel very floral. Do what they're supposed to and then go away.
Yeah.
I think it's interesting that it says it's a combination between a English pale and an Irish red.
Mm-hmm.
Irish reds tend to be very malty and roasty. I get a little less roasty, but I get heavy malt, which is nice. The English pale, in my experience, I've never been to England, but the English pales, they tend to have a little more of a floral note hop. Which is a quick dissipation and is kind of effervescent.
There you go.
So I really see what they're saying it on the bottle.
Mm-hmm.
I see
all
that.
Those things,
I'm a little bit kind of because
you want the barrel aged.
These guys,
not everything has to be barrel aged. I don't believe I'm saying that, but not everything has to be barrel aged.
I know, but they do such like crazy good barrel aged, mm-hmm. and this one isn't.
And but this is fantastic still.
I think I would like to have this barrel aged. It's a really good beer. And I was kind of anticipating barrel aging, I think, when I bought it. And then I'm just looking at it and I went, wait, this one doesn't say barrel aged. I bought like four or five different ones. And this was the only one that did say barrel aged. So I was like, hey, Carissa, let's drink this one. And she was like, oh, I like Ritz.
That's good.
I like that brewery. And
I'm not mad at it.
I'm kind of surprised at how clean it is. Mm. I would like to see this one barrel aged. I like most beers barrel aged. but just the way it sits.
It's fantastic. I like it.
It's pretty nice. It's weird. It kind of has like my favorite things from an English pale and an Irish red.
Yeah. Come on.
Like you put them together.
There you go. Did what it said it's gonna do. Truth in advertising.
Which really doesn't happen very often. Let's be honest. Does it?
Not a lot anymore.
Overall I'm pleased with this.
I am too. I like it.
As long as you don't think, it's gonna be barrel aged and it isn't. I mean, if you just read it. You gotta read it.
Can't make assumptions.
Right. But overall, I'm pretty pleased. And I mean, we read the bottle. That was all we did before this beer.
Yeah.
And I like it.
I like it.
I mean, if you understand what an Irish red is and what an English pale is, and you say, that's the blend. I think you're going to be pleasantly happy. I mean, you're going to be, I don't want to say pleasantly surprised, because you shouldn't be surprised.
You'll just be pleased.
You'll be going to be, yeah, you're going to be, it's going to be pleasant. Mm-hmm. If you're not sure about those, you might be pleasantly surprised. Mm-hmm. There is a hop note. It's not offensive.
Yeah, it's not huge.
There's a big malt.
I'm never mad at that.
But it's the way it should be.
I'm never mad at that.
Yeah. I'm just happy with this one.
That's good. I like it.
Well, if you guys are happy with the review, hit me with a like. It lets me know you care. And it lets YouTube know that this was a good video and they should show it to much more people. I will see what I can find to put about this in the description. You'll also find my merch link, my social media links. Let's get down there. Let's have some fun. I'd like to talk to you guys about this beer or something similar or something different that you think I ought to find. I really like talking to folks down there in the comments. It's fun. I find beers that I need to look for. I also just like enjoying hearing people tell me they like the videos and they like that beer. You know, it's something neat. Mm-hmm. Now, let's see. Let's go ahead and get down to it. Did you dig it?
Yes.
Yes, I did too. Would you have another?
Yes.
I really would. Mm-hmm. I do want to preface this. When I bought it, I thought it was barrel aged just because this brewery does that. And this one wasn't, but I'm really cool with that.
Yeah, I'm okay with
it. Does it have seekability? I don't think these guys have really, like, nationwide distribution. I mean, they're in Kentucky. I'm in Tennessee.
Yeah, they're not that far.
So I can find it. I find it a lot easier in Kentucky. But I do Beer Adventure in Kentucky because I'm not really that far from Kentucky. I'm an hour or so. When we go for day trips and shit, I like to go to Kentucky sometimes hunting beers. Now, Would it be with food? I really think it would be. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can see this one be very, very good with food.
Yes.
Pick six worthy.
Oh, definitely.
Beyond a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah.
I can even see putting multiple in a pick six. Mm-hmm. This is a good beer.
It is good.
All right. Now, when we rate them numerically, we like to do a 1 to 10. 1's the lowest, 10's the highest.
7.
I'm right there with you on 7. It is
a good solid 7.
Well above average. It's fantastic. I think if it was barrel aged, it'd be an 8. Hint, hint. Come on, Lexington. Give me this one in the barrel.
These guys are bold.
I have. You guys have spoiled me on your barrel aged beers, man. They're so good. But hey, you know, take bourbon and beer, two things I really like, put them together, super duper. I don't know that I've ever had a half Irish red, half pale.
It's good. But I like it. It works.
They used the things I like from both, and put them together. So I'm happy. Mm-hmm. I like this beer. I'll drink it again. And to your next beer adventure.
Cheers.